the family. That's what it's all about.
My name's Tony Gnocchi. I'm the head of the Mafia.
So on a day-to-day basis, what are the normal things you get up to? What kind of things do you do for your family?
This and that. Bits of work, should we say. We're the top dogs. There ain't no one higher than us. It's us and no one else. In my eyes, we run the city.
The sweet, sweet memories you gave of me. You can't beat the memories you gave of me.
Take one fresh and tender kiss.
The memories you gave of me.
Add one stolen night of bliss.
You can't beat the memories you gave of me.
One girl, one boy, some grief, some joy, memories are made of this.
Is this all confidential then, yeah? So it's gonna be, yeah? Cool, okay. Hello, my name is Carlo Cenarazzo and I am the head of the Gnocchi family.
All your time in this family, in this business, what's the worst thing that you've done?
Hard question, isn't that? There was once this guy, part of a rival family, you see, and he was bad for business. So we got him, tortured him for a few days. I did that personally. Shouldn't really be saying this stuff, should I, to be honest? But, yeah, a lot of stuff, man. You don't want to know about it.
Like, what effect does this have on you? And, like, how have you come to live with that?
That's a bit of a stupid question, isn't it? This is where you got to live now. There's no honest way of living now. If you want to be big, if you want to make money, no honest way of living.
More than just business to you, is it? A way
it's
of life now?
Life.
Hi, my name is Tyrone. I'm the Mafia boss of the Gnocchi. Nice to meet you. How I got into this? Pretty big question to ask, you know? It's a lineage, it's family, it's history. What does blood relation got to do with it? As I told you, this is history. This is a Mafia family. We are the Gnocchis. Seen a lot of bad stuff. A lot of things have happened. Most believe by my hand. That's why I'm the Mafia boss. Without doing these bad things, you don't get the respect, you know? Many people died, you know, that's the way it has to be. Because I know I'm not going to get caught. Never. It's not me.
We're at the family church. I've come here all my life. Religion's a big part of this community and it enforces loyalty in the family. My father's buried here, his father before him. Been coming here since I was born and I was baptized here, married here. I'll be buried here as my sons will, as their sons will, and hopefully for many generations to come. Yeah, little Carlo comes along sometimes and he's a bit too young to understand, you know, everything about the Holy Trinity, like the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit all into one, but you don't like to think about it when they're your kids, but you don't have a choice in this life. It's the path, it's the life that you take. You don't have a choice. You're born into it and there ain't no way out. You can leave, but you'll never escape it.
So how important is loyalty in the family? Family is everything, mate, you know that. My dad always used to say, familia es tutto. So my dad was Italian, you see, and obviously back in Italy, religion is very important.
Well, as you can see, we're at the old family church. My dad used to take me all the time.
It's beautiful, isn't it? It's nice scenery, isn't it? You come in when you want to get all the shit you done out your head.
nice and tranquil. You know what I mean? Yeah, weddings, quite a few weddings. More funerals than weddings, to be honest. More bad stuff happening here. My dad's actually buried in the back here. I come here just to relax, do you know what I mean? It's a bit of a weird place to come relax, but it's nice and tranquil.
Why have you brought us here today?
Why have I brought you here today? Well, see, the thing about Matthew is, it's all about the family. And all my family's here. So I come here to be with my family. You know, it's an honor to be in their presence. Even though they may not be here today, I'm just coming here to spend time with them. It's important to me. This is the family church. It's been part of family for quite a long time, actually. It's a really good place to come and just embrace the history. You get a real feeling of the atmosphere, what it was like for my father to sit here in this place. You know, he would come here sometimes, just have a moment of peace to himself. Religion is central, to be part of the family, in fact. Something we hold very dear to us. Without religion, we are nothing. Without the mafia, we are nothing. They come hand in hand. It's just the way things work.
So you see this guy here? This is Donnie. Yeah, and he owes me
a bit of money. Don't you, Donnie?
I didn't do nothing, boss.
Where's my money, Donnie?
I didn't do nothing, boss.
You know what you owe me, don't you?
I didn't do nothing, boss.
How much you owe me? Say it. Tell the camera. How much you owe me?
A few thousand dollars.
A few thousands.
Hey, get that camera out of my face.
What's gonna happen if you don't pay me right now? What's gonna happen?
It's
hacking in, boss. No, it's not. And we're gonna relax a bit, aren't we? Come here. Fix yourself up, alright?
Thank you.
Now listen, yeah? You have a week. 1 week. Look at me. Eyes up, yeah, you've got 1 week, yeah? Yeah?
Yes.
Fix yourself, go on, let's get out of here.
So this church has been around for about 572 years. You know, it's
hey.
A place that demands. What are you doing here? Huh?
What are you doing around here, man? Huh?
You know why I'm here.
I know why you're here. What?
I'm gonna kill you.
I'm
gonna cheese you.
I'm gonna kill you, man. What are you talking about? Huh? You crazy?
You wanna do this here?
Are you crazy?
We're gonna do this here.
We ain't doing this here.
What are we gonna do, bro?
You doing around here, man? You wanna fight? We'll fight like a man. Come on.
Fine.
We'll fight like a man.
Let's do it, man. Bro.
Don't do it. No, don't do it!
So who was the leader before you?
It would be Carlo Generazzo Gonocci. But when he took me in, when I started to learn what he was doing, the difference he was making, the money he was making, of course, he showed me the ropes, he taught me how to do things. Obviously, when he passed away, he handed the mantle over to me. That was my blood right.
Do you mind speaking about his death? Is that a sensitive topic or...?
No, I don't think I want to talk about that. I don't want to bring it up. No. Next question, please.
So obviously the Roma family, were they involved in the death of Carlo?
It's a name I don't like to hear, to be quite honest with you. Brings back some bad memories. You know, they were never a mafia family we had any good relations with. We hated them. We despised them, you know. We were better than them, but we never got the respect that we deserved. Yeah, that's how he died. It was them. They killed him. They took him from me. So no, I don't want to talk about the Roma family. I don't even want to hear their name again.
It's widely known that the Roma family, you've never really reached the heights of it.
No, don't. Don't you dare do it. Don't do it. No. Don't mention them. I just told you not to mention them. You're mentioning them. Huh? You trying to piss me off? What's wrong with you? I came out of here from respect. Are you doing that? You know, I'm done with this. I'm done.
So, you seem to never reach the heights that the Roma family did.
What kind of question is that?
fucking question is he asking? You're gonna let him fucking say that? F this, man. This.
Okay, and last question. The Romas. What are your feelings towards them, your family? How do you feel about them?
We don't speak about the Romas.
Not even a little bit right now, no? Just...
No, don't say that name in front of me again.
Okay.
Or any of my family. I'm not dealing with you bastards anymore. I didn't come here for this shit.
After all my years in Mafia Boss, I learned one thing. You win, or you die.